Hi, welcome to Lachlan Likes a Thing, a show where I take a thing and see whether or not I like it. Now, the thing we're looking at in this video is the Surface Pro, which is Microsoft's 10-inch Windows 8 professional tablet computer. Now, it might be a bit late to be making a Surface Pro video considering the new Intel processors are just around the corner, but actually the Surface Pro only just recently came out in Australia. So I just wanted to make a video to give some of my impressions of the device. So I've been using the Surface Pro daily for about 2 weeks now, and I actually got it to replace an 11-inch MacBook Air, a Nexus 7 tablet, and a medium-sized Wacom digitizer drawing tablet. So this video is just going to go through how the Surface Pro compares in terms of pros and cons versus all the devices that it's meant to be replacing. So how does the Surface Pro compare to a lightweight laptop? Well, this is my trusty mid-2010 11-inch MacBook Air, and I really like this machine. I've used it for basic internet browsing, for taking notes during lectures, and it's been really great. It's survived through all kinds of things, survived being dropped, having a cup of water poured on it, all sorts of things, but it has been getting a bit long in the tooth. So here's what I like about the Surface Pro compared to the MacBook Air. As a Mac user who's come from 6.5 years of using a Macintosh and Mac OS X, I actually really like Windows 8 as a touch-based operating system. Now, thankfully, I didn't have to go through that whole transition period from Windows as a desktop mouse and keyboard operating system to Windows 8 with the whole modern interface and the touchscreen. I've just been using it as a touchscreen interface, and in that respect, I think it's really great. I love being able to just reach out and zoom in and out of web pages when I want to read them a bit more closely. I love being able to multitask with just gestures and flicks. And with the included stylus that comes with the Surface Pro, I really like just being able to swap between the touchscreen and the stylus and the keyboard and the trackpad, and really mixing it up with those interfaces and input methods so that I can do whatever works best. And in that respect, it's better than Mac OS X because you don't have to juggle windows, you don't have to make sure the windows don't steal focus from each other. So that's what I really like about Windows 8 as a touchscreen interface for small screens. So in terms of battery life, I get about the same between the Surface Pro and the MacBook Air, although of course with the new processors for the MacBook Air, that equation changes quite significantly. So here's what I don't like about the Surface Pro compared to a laptop like the MacBook Air. Firstly, I got the type cover for the Surface Pro, and although it works and it's okay and it's a passable keyboard, it's not nearly as nice to type on as the 11-inch MacBook Air's keyboard or I guess any other laptop keyboard, just because there's not much travel in the keys, they're a little spongy, and because the type cover is not a kind of rigid element of the whole body of the Surface Pro, unless you're typing on a flat surface like a desk or anything like that, the type cover can get quite flaky in how it picks up key presses, so it's not fantastic to be using it in a casual kind of position. Compared to the 11-inch MacBook Air, where you can kind of use the keyboard lying up or sitting down or anything like that, and the keyboard is much nicer that way. The other thing about the Surface Pro is that the kickstand is not variable in angle, it only goes out one angle. It can be quite hard to find a good position sometimes with the Surface Pro unless, again, you're sitting on a flat desk. The other thing is that although it's relatively light, all the weight distribution on the Surface Pro is in the screen rather than divided between the screen and the keyboard. So it's very difficult, again, to use on any situation where it's not just sitting on a desk because it kind of tips forward or backwards just because the screen is relatively heavy compared to this Surface here. So as a laptop, although you can get away with it, I don't recommend the Surface Pro if you're gonna do a lot of typing. It's just not well suited for that kind of thing. So how does the Surface Pro compare to a tablet computer? Well, you can probably guess my answer because you can see that I've wiped my Android tablet and I'm preparing it to sell it to a friend. I actually got this Nexus 7 as a replacement for my 11-inch MacBook Air when I poured a cup of water on it and I thought it was just never gonna come back. But after a few months, I managed to bring it back, the MacBook Air, from the dead. So since then, I've never actually really used the Nexus 7. I don't actually think tablets are all that useful for me personally because you can't really type very well on them. They're not great for multitasking, so I don't really like them. I don't really think that you can get a great deal of work done on them. And anything that you can do on a tablet, you can do on your smartphone. So I've never been a big fan of the tablet operating systems, even after using them for a bit. In that respect, I think the Surface Pro absolutely blows away any tablet operating system. Just with Windows 8 Professional, you can run desktop applications, you can multitask with all these panels, and it works much nicer. Even though it's heavier and, you know, it's harder to use with one hand and the battery life is a little less, I think that this is a great device to use as a tablet computer. That said, the Surface Pro obviously costs many times the price of just a casual internet web browsing tablet. So if you just wanted to do casual web browsing and content consumption, the tablets are probably a better bet than getting a $1,000 machine to, you know, watch movies and browse the web on. So lastly, how does the Surface Pro compare to a dedicated sketching device like the Wacom Intuos tablet? Well, this is actually my favorite aspect of the Surface Pro, and this is where I think anyone who does art or design really should be looking at the Surface Pro as a really wonderful tool. I am an art student, and I would have loved to have had a machine like the Surface Pro during my undergraduate years. It would have been fantastic. The best part of this machine is that with the stylus and the touchscreen, you basically get a cheap Wacom Cintiq tablet, except the whole computer is built into it. And what's really nice is that you can do sketching just by, you know, directly drawing on the screen, and it becomes almost like a magic sketchbook where you can kind of zoom in and out and adjust the paper and erase infinite amount of times. So it's really nice that way. One bad thing is that the stylus on the Surface Pro does require some calibration, and the default calibration routine on the Surface Pro is not very well explained and it's not very accurate. So I might make another video that just explains how you can accurately calibrate this stylus. The other unfortunate thing is that for programs like Photoshop, these are still Windows 8 desktop applications and they haven't been optimized for a touchscreen interface. So on this 1080p screen on the Surface Pro, all the UI elements are absolutely tiny and it's very hard to actually select anything. Now, once you blow it up to a big screen like this, it's actually quite usable, but if you're gonna do on the go kind of stuff, I haven't really been trying to use Photoshop on the Surface Pro tablet yet, just because the screen elements are too small. One really nice thing about the Surface Pro screen is that once you calibrate it using a hardware calibrator, it's very color accurate. You can read some of the measurements on Anantech. It's a really nice screen, and it's almost as good as a full-size desktop screen in terms of color accuracy. So overall, do I recommend the Surface Pro? Well, if you're looking to replace a laptop and you're gonna do a lot of typing, then no, I don't think the Surface Pro is a great option. If you're looking for something like a tablet that you can use casually, but you can also do a great deal of work on, I think the Surface Pro is really nice in that respect. And if you can think of things that you want to do with this stylus and the digitizer, if you can think of how this would improve your workflow, absolutely, I think that you should jump on the Surface Pro or at least have a play around with it, because this Wacom digitizer is what, in my opinion, makes the Surface Pro a really kind of magical device. If you can't think of any reason why you would need a stylus, then honestly, I don't think you should get the Surface Pro. It's as simple as that. For me, I really like using the Surface Pro. It's gonna be a keeper for me. I'm gonna sell off the Nexus and the Wacom tablet, but I'm probably gonna keep the MacBook Air just for those situations where I know I'm gonna have to do a lot of typing. That said, this is going to be my go-to computer that I'm going to take around in a bag with me all day. It's a really nice machine, and despite everything that everyone has said about Windows 8, coming from a Mac user for 6.5 years, I think it's actually a pretty good operating system. Anyway, thanks for watching this video. I hope it's helped you if you're kind of curious about the Surface Pro and you're wondering if it's the right machine for you. Thanks to everyone who's liked my other videos and subscribed to my channel. I have a Facebook page now, so you can check me out at facebook.com/LachlanLikesAThing. And also I tweet at Twitter at LachLikesAThing. So hit me up and we can have a conversation about the year. Anyway, enjoy the rest of your week.